Ever since my friend Maia told me about a mysterious Spanish fruit called Nespero, which grows in the mountains, I've been desperate to try it.
It's amazing that I haven't actually heard of these before. Ever. I guess, like, would that one be?
So this is a good one. So you go like that, you peel it. Then you bite into it.
And these grow all over Spain or?
No, in this region in particular.
Anywhere else in the world? Have you ever found
them?
They're
originally from China.
Huh.
I don't know when they came to Spain, but there's a town in La Cayosa.
What?
Like have they mostly grow them under netting in not greenhouses but netted because of the wind.
Mm-hmm. And to stop people from scrumping them like we're doing.
Yeah, they're kind of a delicacy. Not really a delicacy, but they get damaged. They're only in season for like a month and they get damaged quite quickly and go brown. So you can't.
I've never had them before. I've never even heard of them before. You can smell them fermenting. I bet you could make really nice wine out of these.
Yeah. Sometimes they put them in sangria.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Love that the lemons are growing wild. Hello, Pepe. Oh, there's loads of them.
My grandmother took some back to England and planted, but they never fruited.
Hmm.
Cool. The last 5 years or so, it's got this really terrible, there's been a plague.
Uh-huh.
Can you see those little white things on the leaves? So it's basically killed off all of these. They're quite interesting inside, but the plague that they have is, what do they use for red paint? What's a red paint called?
Cochineal.
Cochineal, so it's cochineal. So basically if we find one that's accessible, if you scratch the white stuff,
yeah.
You think it's like a fungus or whatever. It's not, it's loads of little
beetles.
And it goes bright red.
Oh my goodness!
So, see, but we can't reach that leaf very easily, yeah. So we'll find another one. So when you see one that's got white on it,
yeah.
You scratch it and it goes bright red and it's cochineal.
Ooh, that's the stuff of folklore, isn't it? It's like the plant bled.
Yeah. But it's basically killed off. These types of cactuses were all over, everywhere.
Yeah.
Quite nice ones. They're the ones that produce the prickly pears.
Oh, the edible ones?
Yeah.
Okay.
And it's killed them. And in Morocco too, they were all dead. In Greece, they were still alive when I went to Greece.
Sorry, so little cactus.
But yeah, so it's kind of wiping out. And I don't know if the cochineal just live on that cactus or what, but...
Okay, so we just came out for a little walk, and both Maia and I love abandoned buildings. So we've decided that we might go and try to find some over the weekend, just like check them out. And whilst we were on our walk, she said, oh, well, there's actually an abandoned building just down here. So this is not part of our abandoned building themed episode, but we're just going to go and see if we can find one now. Is this it?
Well, there's that one that we can't get. But then this one looks like it's massively fallen in since last year.
Okay.
All this side wall has fallen down.
And why do these buildings get abandoned? Because there's quite a lot of them.
Yeah, it's really fallen down. Look, they've taken Just, I guess, people used to live off the land and have a house kind of out there, and then they moved down. People, like, an old house is really expensive to renovate.
Mm-hmm.
Imagine how much that
would. Which is kind of crazy when you look at what it's made from, because, like, it doesn't look like it would be expensive.
Yeah, but then they don't build like that anymore, so then you've got to rebuild it. And they all, see up there, so they used to be beams, and then they'd put canis, which is canes from the river.
Oh, I see.
And they'd
yeah,
put
yeah.
the tiles straight on top and plaster the bottom of it. That's actually what my house is made of.
Oh, I see. So those canes are from the river?
Yeah, yeah, like river, like, yeah, canes, like, not quite bamboo, but...
Yeah, reeds.
Reeds, yeah.
Got it.
And let's see what's
really
in here.
Fascinating, isn't it? Looks like this has been abandoned a really long time.
Yeah, but this wall has fallen down, because last time I was here, this wall was up.
When were you here last?
Oh, like 3 months ago.
Uh-huh.
So there were some heavy winds, and you can see it here on the left. They've just, like, pushed it aside.
Yeah, not one for your renovation projects.
Yeah. But it's quite a nice location.
Yeah.
If it was up for, maybe not if it was up for sale.
Oh. Wow, yeah. Yeah, I think that one's lost to time, isn't it?
Yeah, you'd have to knock it down completely and
start again.
But yeah, perfect location.
Looks like somebody's been here recently, like, had a fire with some charcoal and things on the ground. There's a house in the village that, is it abandoned?
Well, it hasn't been lived in for years. It's put up for sale. It was up for sale. The neighbour said the owner kept coming and locking it, and then the wind would come and blow it open.
Sure it's the wind. Strong wind to unlock the door. So quiet up here, actually. All the olive trees. Can you get up there, do you think? Or is that asking for trouble?
You can get up here.
Oh gosh, can I get up here? I'm going to stop filming and see if I can get up there. So what do you think the rooms were? Can you tell by looking? That looks like it must have been a kitchen, because that's a fire, isn't it? Or a bedroom?
Not sure. I don't think that. I don't know. That must. I mean, it's got a
mattress in
stuff,
it. Yeah.
But I don't know if that's. It was originally, because maybe I wouldn't be able to close that beam. But I don't know whether originally.
You found the fireplace?
Yeah, the fireplace covered and door out the back.
Oh, you're right to look up above. That happened, you know, the earthquake in Bukavu in 2008? That was the same thing in Changugu,
yeah,
over
really?
The border. Is after the earthquake, all of the cracks appeared above the doors and on the facade, and people weeks afterwards were just getting killed by the facade falling on them.
Yeah.
Because you don't think to look up, really, do you?
Actually, it's probably quite nice. It's got a really nice staircase. Really
nice, that's a fire plug.
Yeah.
Oh, that's somebody dying.
Peppy, our protection dog. Yeah, that is a really nice big fireplace. It's got a couple of tiles left.
I can use that in the other house.
What's that?
That goes at the edge of the stairs. I've not seen one like that. That's really pretty.
Oh, the banister.
Yeah.
Well, I don't think anybody's using it, to be fair. It's in bad condition, it's rusting, isn't it? And that's the bed frame at the back.
Yeah.
I get a nice feel from this house. I don't feel like it's... No. Feels like it was loved and people lived here and... And now they don't. Oh, I can see through the foam. So from the top of the stairs, the window at the top looks right out across the mountain. Beautiful view of the mountain. It would have been a really nice place to wake up. Okay. I should probably get moving before I have to call in my health insurance. I'm not sure if looking at abandoned buildings classes as like a dangerous pastime. Dangerous sport. Okay, so we've just taken a little walk up the side of a hill to look at this, which is a cave. Maya, what cave is it?
This cave? Oh, look what I've just found in the cave.
Who is that? Oh, sod off.
There's okay. A picture on the side. Uh-huh. But this cave has got a fire in. My mum said that before, the kids used to come and leave messages in the ceiling or something.
Do you reckon there's any in there? Oh, doesn't echo. Oh, yeah, a little bit. God, this is sort of Neolithic style cave, isn't it? Like, okay. Oh, there's bats!
Are there?
Yes, there's a pipistrelle! There's only one. He's gone. Sorry, bat. Didn't mean to upset you. So they used to leave messages on the ceiling.
Well, and bits of paper, like, hidden around, my mum said.
Oh, like notes?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm not seeing anything.
Yeah, I don't think they do it anymore. This was before I came.
Okay, now they just WhatsApp each other. Maybe we should leave a note. Oh, I like this. This is cool. Oh, there's tea lights in here as well. Probably the meeting place of the local Wiccan Association.
Yeah, we could come and do a fire.
Pepe seems completely nonplussed by the whole thing, so good energy. Not an upset or a bothered dog. Hello, Dalmatian dog.
Almond, Mariam. Have you seen an almond fresh from the tree before?
Are you taking the piss? Are you taking the piss? Are almond trees, they always have the black... Have they always got the black bark?
Yeah.
That's really cool.
No, Peppy. No, it's an almond and I'm trying to crack it. Don't chew it. Peppy, it's an almond.
Pepe has eaten the almond.
No, please don't swallow that.
Is this an almond?
Oh, yeah, there are.
Yeah? That's an almond. Oh, they come off really easily. Hold on. They don't smell of anything. Okay, hold on. Pepe's going to eat it. He's going to eat it. Oh, he's still chewing on the almond. Okay.
Oh, that's a bit of a dead almond. But yeah, that's it. Oh, there's two in there.
That's the almond.
They're quite nice and full. They're completely ripe.
So you can eat them when they're green?
Yeah, they're kind of soft. They're not hard yet. Okay. They're not bitter.
I've never seen a palm tree like that before.
It looks slightly... No, maybe not. Like,
two legs parted.
Yeah.
Yes.
Very odd legs.
Very odd legs, yes. Body erotic palm. Out.
Okay, so we're walking home at the moment and there's another abandoned house. And that's a reservoir for water for the area, we think. Yeah, we've come from just over there. This is a well, right? This was a well?
Yeah. Oh no, but that's Alcantarilla, so that's the where the toilet goes. Oh god, look at those bricks coming down. This also looks like it's in a worse state than...
Somebody's tried to patch that up, haven't they?
Yeah.
Oh, I see the flowers on the cactus. Yes, this is one of the very rare non-diseased cactuses. Oh, I think the one next to it's got it though. It's starting to go a bit dark. Maybe it's been protected by the wall for a while. Lovely sea view. Will be a wonderful place to have a house. Room down there for a pool.
And you're quite close to the village, actually.
Oh, there's a little baby bird. I think it's like...
The... Hello, baby bird. Yes, I see.
Oh, there's two. Can you see there's one there and one behind? I think they've just come out of the nest.
Hello, welcome to the world. Welcome to the world, little one. Definitely liking this oven. I love it when the plants and the ivy are just coming, spilling out of the windows. It's kind of creepy.
Yeah, imagine they had it as like a weekend house.
It's fairly fabulous. Beautiful views. Incredible writing retreat. Quite like to move in there.
Maybe we should buy it.
I was going to say, how do you go about tracking down people if you wanted to?
Well, quite often, like, I ask my neighbour, so quite often, like, an old person will own it, and they, like, they just don't want
to sell it. I suppose they're full of old sort of memories and things.
Yeah, like this lot.
Really old school sort of.
That's quite cool, isn't it?
Very nice picture. Just imagine if this was covered in wisteria or something, or bougainvillea, and... Oh, that'd be gorgeous. What a place to sit. I really like this.
Can we try and buy it?
Curious to know how much it is.
Yeah, if it's for sale.
If it's for sale.
That's the challenge. There's a window there.
If somebody snatches it off the pole, I'm running, screaming.
I love these little birds.
Oh my god.
What?
Oh, come and have a look at this. It's a whole bloody bathroom.
Oh my goodness.
You see it?
Yeah.
Oh. It's fully tiled and everything.
What if we're sitting on the toilet?
Well, I think I'm slightly in love with this place. Beautiful view of the mountain. Crazy fact about this mountain is because we're standing here, that side looks like it's taller. But if you're on the other side of the mountain, it's actually that bit that is much, much taller, but it doesn't look it from this side. It's a really weird optical illusion. Oh, that was very cool. Hello, Mr. Pep. Okay, that was really good fun. I love abandoned buildings, and it's so much fun just thinking about what the buildings used to be used for, who used to live there, you know, and talking about whether or not you could renovate something like that. I mean, just look at that view. You've got the mountain right behind us, and in the opposite direction, we've got the sea. So you've got a sea view, a mountain view. It's really fantastic. But it's definitely very dilapidated. I find it fascinating just the mountains are just so imposing. Like, it's flat, 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 then fuck off, huge, great big mountain.
Yeah, yeah, and especially here, like, you go inland a bit, like you were saying, and it's just stunning mountain. Like, so many people come for the sea and never even
see the mountains, yeah.
Loads of people come here for rock climbing and walking, and it is quite...
It's nice. It's lovely in the evening when it's this kind of temperature. And...
Oh, it's not working. They're dead.
Probably. Eating it all up.
Because when my mum told me, I didn't believe her, and then I did it, and I was like, yeah.
Oh yeah. My goodness.
Those ones were dead, but the look at that.
That's crazy. It does look like the cactus is bleeding. And those are the bugs they used to dye things with.
Yeah. And they don't even look like bugs, do they? They just look like it. But look at that red colour. It's like, wow.
Looks as something out of a horror movie, that.
Yeah.
And they're killing all the cactuses.
They're across the Mediterranean, yeah.
Sorry, little cactus. Fight back! Fight back! It looks like hundreds of people probably came here at one point. So did every village have one of these? And it's just where people came to do their washing?
Yeah. But that's actually not here, that's the fountain down the road.
Okay.
That might be here, I guess, but it looks a bit different, doesn't it?
I guess if there was a house here, then...
Yeah, or maybe that was the house. Could that be...
Established in 1914, goodness.